finally you're having pain-free sex, but the desire's not there anymore, let's talk. I'm Pauli, a women's health physical therapist, and this is Beyond the V Women's Health. I am on a mission to shed light on the lack of care, the lack of conversation about these uncomfortable topics, and to create resources for you and provide help. I created this channel because no mom or woman should have to struggle when there are answers. So you've done all my videos, you've implemented everything that I've said, and sex is comfortable and pain-free, just like you wanted, but the desire's not there. I hear this all of the time with my patients, and it continues to break my heart. Let me walk you through a couple steps that I share with my patients all the time. The first thing I would do is I would go back to basics. Go back to the reasons that you two first fell in love. I might even write a list of all the reasons that you love them. I might even write a list of all the reasons that you love them now. Go back and start doing some of those same things that you did when you were dating. Then what I would do, and as weird as this sounds, I would consider what your bases are. So maybe first base is holding hands, second base is kissing, third base is fondling, fourth base is penetrative intercourse. It can be that, it could be something totally different. This is your desire and whatever you want to determine it as. I've had patients before where that was just really overwhelming, that there wasn't enough bases in between first, second, third, and home. And so what we did is we had different layers of the bases. So maybe first base for them was holding hands. Second base was snuggling. Third base was like a quick smooch. And fourth base was maybe making out with tongue. I only say this just to kind of illustrate what it might need to be for you, because sometimes we might have a lot of trauma associated with the pain that we are experiencing with sex, whether that was before this partner, before this spouse. So maybe your layers of figuring out what a home run is or making it all the way looks like for you, it might need to be in different layers. And this is your journey. So take it however you need to. The second thing that I would do is I might look into different types of foreplay that maybe you've never tried before. One of my favorite tools that I like to use or suggest for my patients, I even use it myself, is a game called All Night Love Affair. There's cards in there that I'll read with my patients just to kind of give them some ideas to maybe kind of rediscover different ways of being touched or kissing or removing different senses, like being blindfolded. That might be something to help. Another thing that is really helpful is having good communication with your partner or spouse or whomever this is with. It's important for you two to be on the same page, and even though they may not understand exactly where you're coming from, at least letting them know, because this is intimacy again, that you being intimate with them may not necessarily need to be physical right away, but you being intimate with them, sharing what you're actually feeling, can be really helpful. Feel free to see a sex therapist or a family and marriage counselor if that's what you're needing. The reason that it's important to do some of these things is we need to rewire your brain. For the longest time, intercourse, intimacy, sex has been probably something you've avoided because it's been painful. Because really, who wants to do something that's painful? Not many of us. So your brain has seen intimacy and sex as something painful. This is your opportunity to kind of rewire your brain to help it see, oh, hey, and some of these things will help start producing some of this rewiring and this re-education for your brain. But doing these things and creating pleasure again is gonna start hitting some of those specific places in your brain that help trigger the appropriate hormones and endorphins to help you start feeling pleasure again, to help you start feeling desire again. Because once we start feeling something good, like when we eat something sweet, it hits a particular part of our brain, and for a lot of us, it makes us want more. So if you get to have a really incredible experience with your partner touching you in a new way, or touching you in a way because you've rekindled some of those thoughts and those feelings, that's gonna start changing your response. And now, when you're not being intimate and when you're not touching, then your brain's gonna say, hey, remember when we did that one time and that felt real good? Your brain's gonna start craving that, and then your desire will come. This can be a lengthy process for some, and it can be short for others. So if you need help, truly, reach out to a sex therapist or a family and marriage counselor. If you need help with your pelvic floor or returning back to pain-free intercourse and you're local to Utah or the surrounding areas, reach out to me. If not, check the link below to find someone near you. I want to change the conversation on women's health and I need your help. Like, subscribe, and click the notification bell so you know when new videos are up, and share these with friends or other women that you know would benefit from this. I believe that it's possible for you to improve your health and that you're worthy of getting this help because you're an heiress and a queen and everything in between.